Alright, let's do it, man. Let's do it.
Alright, can I get Zach and Jabal to get at Zach and Jabal, though, you guys are playing once. Sup and B2, you guys are playing next. Sup and B2.
Drive.
What?
Nice, dude. No, let's go for up air. I thought you were PIing up. Yeah, I messed that up.
Drop off.
Yeah, drop off back here.
Yeah.
Alright, let's go to...
Yes, sir, commentary.
Alrighty.
So we are live for Battle for Bell 7.
It's your boy Slim Thick and Bukake.
Don't ever call me that again.
Yes.
So y'all have seen a good chunk of the bracket already without commentary because somebody made me think the commentary was just not working.
Hey, look, listen.
So we got Chadbrochill 60. That's one of the best tags I've ever heard in my life.
Yo, Chadbrochill 69, best tag, bro.
Chadbrochill 69 versus LightBrand.
Yeah.
versus Raisin Brand, bro. But Ike Pelotano, very interesting matchup. And it's funny because they both kind of look for the same thing, but they do it in such different ways.
You know, everybody's just going to try to hit that nair, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, get some confirms.
Yeah, you know, like they just really want you above them. You know, Ike with that big ass rag nail. New York, everybody knows about that. Early Ultimate for the first like month and a half, everyone was like, Ike
shit was broke, bro. Yeah, like,
and then it's the same shit with Palu, you know. Palu jumps in the air with Nair, it's like, oh my god, this bitch is broke.
This bitch is broke.
Both kind of less relevant than what they were, but
still good characters.
Yeah, no, definitely still good. Definitely, like, people sleep on Ike, low-key. Mm-hmm. Like not like, I'm not gonna say it's like disturbing, because like, Ike is still like mediocre. But that was actually
a lot better than he was in Smash 4, I'll tell you that much.
Absolutely.
God damn.
He can actually hang now. This is a very interesting start to this game, because most of the last game I seen, Jamie was just kind of controlling the tempo, but now Chadbro is just kind of making Jamie play his game. Jamie's getting some good licks in right now. It's kind of an advantage, but okay.
I mean, even though he doesn't have the percentage lead.
Counter on the
That was crispy. That was crispy.
He can probably live. No, he's dead.
He's dead.
Yeah, he got knocked out too far. I think he jumped before he upbeat. Had to allow that air dodge to get back.
Does Ike only have one up B? On side B?
Is
it kind of like Lil Max?
Well, the thing with side B is, like, it's one of those things where it's, like, it's not like with Max. Like, Ike will get a side B back to hit him out. In that situation where he was, like, if he tried to charge side B, he was just going to be too low to
he wouldn't snap the ledge.
Yeah, so it was, like, it was just not worth it.
Yeah, it makes sense.
Getting them nairs, getting these nair and
up air, good extra credit. Bink.
Ooh.
Nope.
Okay.
Jumping over the explosive flame.
All right.
Yep.
All right. That quick draw cancel to the dash attack.
Yep.
That's an Ike classic, bro. That's such a
that's
staple.
That's a classic
that
classic, bro. That's a whole pickle.
Oh, no. Absolutely. Yeah, no. Just tomato sandwich. All up in that bitch.
Hungry as fuck right now.
I could eat a tomato sandwich for folks.
Yeah, you know, with some mayonnaise, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. There's some pepper. You know what I mean? But, Jamie trying to close this deficit a little bit. It's pretty much even now.
Most definitely.
And both of these characters, maybe more so Palutena than Ike, but both of these characters can kind of just close a deficit real quick if they just land like that one stray aerial they're looking for.
Oh yeah, most definitely.
So it's like, in Ike's case, I mean, he lands that nair in a certain spot, I mean, you just die. So, you know.
Nice.
Jamie definitely the best Ike in the business, at least in this part of the, you know, the spectrum.
I would hope so.
Yeah, I mean, he's probably the only Ike, but nevertheless.
There's only about like two of them. You're so good, Jamie.
Chadbro trying to zone him out real quick. Oh, dude, that invincible bear. Tried to counter the quick draw. Got bear. That whole situation turned to a scramble just because he pulled the trigger too long on that, too early on that counter.
Yeah, if he would have like went off stage and tried to read it and get the counter off like
or
that.
Even if he waited, I think it would have clipped on stage.
You think so?
Yeah, I think so. Like, that counter hitbox is big, and quick draw is kind of a massive hitbox. It hits people on ledge all the time.
Okay.
Yeah, so. Explosive flame. Trying
to go for the up smash. Dash attack, bro.
Nice weight on the quick draw.
That was a great weight.
There.
Into, nope.
Okay, that down was a tilt. Really good quick. Down tilt. Ah, that quick draw just to kind of get back to ledge. Say, hey, man,
bro.
Let me go.
Ooh, the wind box almost clipping and getting him off stage.
Yeah, if he would have got that wind box again, that would have been kind of
cool. Yeah, that would be sick.
Obviously, he probably would have preferred to just hit the F smash.
I mean, either way, you know, sauce.
Jamie trying to set up a little game plan, but, you know,
Chadbro
got to find this kill real quick. He doesn't want this to get too bad, because Ike Rage
is built different.
That's an angry hombre, bro. You don't want to deal with that.
Shit.
Yeah, that's the best way to put it. You know, Ike with any semblance of rage, I mean, he's got probably the most rage you can even, you know, just muster up in this game. So, I mean, it's just like, you know.
Back throw.
Chadbro listening out. He said, you know what?
He said, you know, I'm tired of y'all
get
shit.
Get him out of here.
Tired of y'all shit.
And, you know, 75% in Palu Ike is not an undoable deficit for Palutena. Definitely. mean, you get a couple of aerials, a couple of doubles.
Oh, yeah, like, look at it right now.
Just, yeah,
like,
look at that. Like,
Bink.
I mean, he's already, like, halfway up.
Yeah, you get it.
Oh,
yeah.
Man, the bear.
And I think what did Chadbro win? Had his aerial strings going. But then there would be little windows where it was just kind of like he could have maybe waited, or he maybe could have done something a little bit quicker, had it a little bit tighter. And Jamie was just like, well, you know what? In these windows, I can just.